Welcome back to Just Scribble. I bought this Filofax Malden in the ochre color off the buy-sell trade and wanted to de-ring it to hold a B6 Stalogy or similar sized B6 notebook. And I thought I'd do a video showing you guys how I de-ringed it. So I watched several YouTube videos before I started this process, and most of them said that the best way to remove the rings was to use a drill and drill out the rings. That way you wouldn't damage your leather with a screwdriver or get it scratched up. But nothing really told me which drill bit size worked best. And so I tried several different sizes before I found the one that worked the best and was the most efficient. And so in this video, I have shown you guys each drill bit that I'm testing out, and I've put the size in the little comments so that you can see which ones did and didn't work. But ultimately, I did find the perfect drill bit that worked the best. So now I am trying a larger size drill bit because I realized that maybe the problem was that I wasn't using a drill bit that was thick enough to cut through the screw quickly and easily. And it would be faster if it was bigger and it would cover more area. So I tested the 3/16 and it was perfection. It was really fast, it was easy, it didn't require a lot of pressure or extra work on my part, and it took off the screw rather quickly. So I have sped up all the parts of this video so that you don't have to sit through and listen to the drill forever, but even with it being at a faster speed, you can tell that it was a fairly quick process. So you can see there that I got the top screw from the right-hand side off, and it worked perfectly. And so now I'm taking the bottom one off. The notebook will spin around some if you don't have enough pressure when you're pushing on the drill, but as long as you keep your pressure down, it won't spin too much. And as long as there's nothing sharp or jagged underneath the notebook, your notebook won't get scratched up from spinning around from using the drill. But this is the process and the timeline of kind of getting that second screw off. Occasionally, some little pieces of metal would come off from the screw, and so I would just take them off and move them to the side and then keep drilling. When it actually goes through and it separates the screw from the rings, you kind of feel that pressure release and you know that it works. And so now I'm just taking the rings off and kind of cleaning up the top to take off any extra little pieces of metal that I can get off, just so that it'll be easier to get the metal plate out from inside the Malden. So there is a metal plate in there, and the only way that I know of, or the best way that I know of from videos I watched, to get it out is to actually cut your leather. So I used my Ulfa cutter, and you cut like just underneath the stitching, so it doesn't go all the way through, and I was checking that to make sure, but you cut as close to that stitching as possible so that you don't have a big gash in your notebook and so that it still looks pretty. And so I cut it with my Ulfa cutter, which cuts like butter. I highly recommend this Ulfa cutter. And then I realized that those little screws stick up and you have to kind of get them out of the leather and get the leather to pop up over it, or you can't pull the metal plate up because the screws are attached. So at first I was using a sort of metal nail tool to kind of pop it up, but then I realized it wouldn't work on the other screw because it was too far down. So I got a metal straw, super technical tools here, and I popped the leather up a little bit so that that screw dropped down inside the notebook. That way I could pull it out easily and not damage the notebook. So now I am just pulling that metal plate out, and you can see the screws on there, and it pulled out beautifully, and it was super easy. It wasn't as hard as I thought it was gonna be. But you do have a slice there now in the notebook, so you have to glue it back together. So I debated on using my super glue that I love, but I decided I would use leather cement, which is like a leather glue. You could use either one, but I just applied it kind of to the crease, the opening of where I had cut it, kind of stuck it down in there. And then I used my super technical toothpick to kind of shove the cut piece underneath the stitch line so that you couldn't really tell where I had stitched it. And I just kind of dabbed it on, make sure that it was covered so it would stay glued, and then I left it there to dry. And so I left it for a couple of hours. I think you're supposed to leave it for longer, but I left it to dry. And then when I came back, you couldn't even tell that I had cut it. Like that end and the end that wasn't cut, they didn't look any different. It was awesome. So really the only thing was you have these little holes in there. Then I decided I didn't like the pen loop. And so I thought, oh, I'll cut the pen loop off. So I grabbed my trusty Ulfa cutter again, and I did surgery to the pen loop and removed the pen loop from the Malden. I'm super glad that I did this. The pen loop was kind of raggedy and messed up anyways because I bought this off the buy sell trade and it was used. And my pens don't fit in that pen loop properly, and so I knew I wasn't going to use it. So I was double checking to make sure that I got it as close as I could and that it looked pretty, and it does. And so my notebook is all fixed and de-ringed. But then I decided since it was used that I should clean it and give it a little bit of protection. So I cleaned it with some saddle soap. So this saddle soap that I buy is from Otterwax. It comes in a set. It has their leather balm and their oil and the saddle soap. I really like their products, and so I use that. And so you rub it on until it gets kind of sudsy, and you just kind of rub in a circular motion, and it cleans off any dirt and grime that is on your leather. And so I spent the time to kind of clean it off, and you'll see I'm kind of going crazy with the scrub, but the notebook was definitely dirty. You could tell that it hadn't had any cleaning or conditioning or TLC in a while. And so I gave it a nice cleaning and a nice scrub. And then once you do that, you wipe off any excess. And I just use an old t-shirt of my husband's or like a towel or a rag and just kind of wipe it off. And then after I did that side, I turned it over and I did the same thing to the inside. Obviously, if you do this process of de-ringing and you are using a new Malden or one that you can tell hasn't been used or looks fairly new, you can completely skip this process of cleaning it. But I felt it was important to clean it up and make it pretty. And then after I got it all clean, then I decided I would add a protectant to it just to keep it looking its best and prevent it from getting too dark or dingy or messed up from water stains or grease on your hands from food and things like that. So I use a lot of different leather products depending on the leather that I am treating, and I will try to do some videos in 2020 to show you guys some of the different leather products that I use to care for my leather notebooks. But for this particular one, I decided to use Boot Guard. Jennifer Harvey from Chic Sparrow actually is the one that turned me onto this product, and it has a really nice smell to it. It kind of smells almost like smoky or masculine. It's kind of hard to explain, but it doesn't have a chemical smell, which I like because it doesn't make my notebook smell funny. And it gives a water repellent, water protective kind of coating onto your leather. And so I felt it was good for this Filofax, especially given the fact that it was older and it had some darker spots. I knew that that might happen and get worse if I didn't treat it. And so I added a nice coat of this Boot Guard. You can buy it on Amazon and I'll put the link below. But I applied a nice coat of it to the Malden. I did it inside and outside. And after I got all the areas covered nicely, I left it to sit for a few hours just so that it could soak in and get fully protected. So here is my beautiful Malden that has been de-ringed and cleaned and polished and conditioned. I have added elastic to where the rings were because it will hold a passport insert or even a wallet insert. I may not keep it like that permanently, but I thought I would try it out just to see what I think. This setup, the Malden with the B6 Stalogy, will most likely be my planner in January of 2020. That is my goal or my plan right now for its use and purpose, and I will see how I like it. I may switch it into an e-class in the month of February, but I'm going to try this out in January and give it a go. I hope you liked this video about de-ringing my Malden. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Make sure you're subscribed to my channel. And don't forget to just scribble.